always wanted to be a vet. I saw my first dog, a German Shepherd, coughed out blood in front of me and collapsed and died. That spurred me on wanting to be a vet. Went on to do my undergraduate first in the States at Purdue. Went on to pursue my veterinary degree at Melbourne. Did about a year plus of local practice. In 2008, I decided, hey, I want to move out and set up on my own with like-minded people. You lead by example. I've been continuously educating myself, broadening my knowledge. After getting all the knowledge and experience, I have the extreme desire to pass on this knowledge onto others. As an educator, I guess to educate, you really just need to be knowledgeable. So for that, it encourages you to learn more. And also in everyday life, same with your experience that you gain every day, that helps you more effectively educate and pass this knowledge and skill on to the next person. The police dog unit, I'm there to do consultation on a volunteer basis. We do lectures to all the handlers and trainers and our key officers there. For all my guys over here, I pretty much encourage them, you know, take up courses, improve your skill, we'll find it for you. They go through continuing education every year. They attend seminars, conferences. From my aspect, I'll let them have the time that they need to attend all this. As a sole proprietor, it's definitely an honor, it's a prestigious award. I guess it also serves to acknowledge of what I've gone through over the past decade, the continuing education. But I can assure you, it's not going to be the end of it. Just don't give up, follow your dreams. Easier said than done, but I followed my dreams. I made it, I'm happy. Never stop learning.